Along with securing which devices can access a certain piece of network equipment, you can also create and manage user accounts and assign roles to limit their access on a certain device. Role-based access control allows you to define the rules for those assigned roles and the restrictions that authorize the user to access a certain device. By default, NXOS comes out of the box with four predefined user roles. The first one is network admin, who has complete read and write access to the entire Nexus device. The second one is the network operator, which has complete read access, notice I didn't say write, to the entire Nexus device. These two network roles actually can administer across multiple virtual device contexts, which is a way that we divide a physical switch into multiple logical switches. So these admins and operators have read, write, and read access to any of the physical or virtual switches on a single NXOS device. In contrast to that, we have specific roles that are created to give you administrative credentials for a certain virtual device context. For instance, you may have access to one virtual device context, but not another. And in this case, the VDC admin role gives you read-write access to a specific VDC or virtual device context, whereas the VDC operator only gives you read access to a specific VDC. So if you ever log into a device and you find that your commands aren't working, you may want to check what role that you're logged into, because you may only have read access to the device, or you may not have access to a specific VDC, as your role may be a VDC operator instead of a network operator like you want it to be. You can also create custom roles in the device if the four predefined roles don't meet your needs. You can create these custom roles, and by default, you can have access to the different show, exit, and configure terminal commands. But you can also apply specific rules to these custom roles and allow access based on your custom parameters. For instance, one user may be able to use a certain number of commands or a certain custom command, whereas one user may not. The same thing goes with features that they're allowed to enable or disable, as well as the fact that we can put these features into groups and have a predefined group that a user is able to use or not use.